Welcome to another video of PDF Models. Today we are doing Dorgul. So you see I've got some of it all ready together, but we go through the front wheel. So what you want to do, you've got in your pack, you've got 4 9mm long brass bearings. You do drill that out to 732, push them in and leave them be for now. And what you do then, get your front axle and your drive gear, slide that in. So it's loose. Get one of your wheels, push that on, it's a little bit tricky. Then drop the screw. Screw that little bit. Same to the other side, making sure that you have the wheels the same way around, 90 degrees. Right. One minute. You've got loads of side play. So what I'm going to do, push the bearings up against the wheel either side. So you've got an equal gap between the chassis. Once you've got that and you know it runs free, whack some super glue, weld it around the bearing, around there. Hold those bearings into place. Do that to the back and front bearings. So you've got yourself a rolling chassis. Next, we are going to fit the cylinder. Very easy to do. Two cap head bolts, let's use tweezers, slide that in, there you go. What we'll do is you want to make sure that the hole been drilled out 3mm, so it accepts a 3mm tube. Take the front rear cylinder cover and drill the hole out 3mm so the tube slides through it. We want to do is then slide that on through the cylinder so that is on like that. Next, I've already done it, but as you fit the boiler support and the slide bar holders into place, four bolts, you got the two inner ones, which you can see there, which need to be there countersunk so that the crank connecting rod misses when it's going round, and then the other bolt goes in from the other side going downwards with the head on the top and the nut underneath. A little bit tricky to get the nut on, but use a pair of needle nose pliers so it can be bolted into place, making sure that this goes on the right way, the curve matches the motor mount on that. Next, we're going to fit the connecting rods. On the front wheel, you have the standard Slater's crank pin, so follow their instructions. Next, fit the little brass push. Slide that on. You don't lose it down there. Tiny little 10 PA nut including with the Slater's wheels. Do that. Do the same to the other side. What you want to do is you want to make sure that they do have plenty of play in there, so you might have to open the holes up a little bit for them to work properly. Next, take slide bar holder, the piston rod and crosshead, and bolt the connecting rod to that using a countersunk screw and a 2mm nut. Wind it on so it's loose, put a dab of glue on the thread to stop that from falling out, and glue the 2mm rod into the crosshead. Next, slide that in so it's nice and free. And now the tricky part is around. Have a washer and the rod goes on the top. You have a little tube goes on top of that. Another washer. connecting rod. And then you have a 8BA bolt with a 8BA washer. And then the tricky part is to get all that bolted into the hole. Like so. So you have a working chassis. Repeat on the other side, exactly the same. And making sure that there's no tight spots whatsoever, nice and free, so you can eliminate any other problems that you might come across. Next, on the slide bar holders, your 2mm square holes. You want to clean them out before you fit them. So the 2mm metal square rod will slide through using a pair of pliers. So they slide in to the rear cylinder cover. Same on this side. Fit that one, and what you want to do is you want to make sure that when you look down there, that it is square and still runs nice and smooth. So you know then for a fact that you're going to have no binding spots or anything. So it should look like that. Next, take the motor with your worm gear, very straightforward. Bolt that in to place with some 2.5mm screws, and then when you're happy, bolt up the main drive gear to the axle with a tiny little flat-headed screwdriver, and then you can test run the chassis to make sure all works fine. Right, next, you've got the buffers. These are the same as the Tarflin. So very straightforward. You have three holes, two with hexagon. One at the centre is 3mm for a countersunk bolt. Glue in two 2mm nuts inside, making sure they're pushed all the way down to the bottom. And then what you do is stick that on the front using a 3mm countersunk bolt. So you can get in it. Like so. It goes to the other side. Don't do them up too tight. Put a bit of glue or Loctite onto the buffers. Then you can fit the buffer stops. They only cleaning up and they just get pressed in. A little bit tight, just needs to be a bit cleaned up. Enough from the printed material. So they slide into there, back and front. Next, take the coupling hook. Glue the two halves together. So you can then bolt where you've put the two nuts in, and also covers the countersunk screw onto the front of that, so you can connect your carriages. Next is the body. This comes in one piece. We will need cleaning up in areas due to the 3D printing, but it's fairly flat, so it's quite straightforward. What you want to do, you take your smoke box. Glue your front detailing plate in place, and then you can add all your gauge glasses and regulator and bits of pipe work everywhere all around it. There is a picture in the kit to show you placements of parts. It's exactly the same as Tower Flynn. The only difference is it hasn't got the flat plate at the bottom with the reverse lever on next to it. So the reverse lever comes with the kit, but you have to cut a little piece off so the fits in side there against the wheel arch and the cab body. So what you want to do is you want to bolt that into place in there with one 3mm screw, and then a nut goes inside to bolt that into place. Next, bolt your body on. Take that on it. Four 3mm screws. All the holes have been drilled and tapped, ready for you just to bolt up. And I do occasionally miss holes, which I do apologise for. But it's a bit tricky. Screw that into place, screw that into place. So you've got your cab, and also that'll be bolted into place by a box. So you're left with cab. Take your wheel arches. You have two types on this one. One's got a little arch, and the other one's just round. The arch one, looking from the front, goes on this side. Glue that over the wheel in place against the boiler support. A little guide makes it a bit easier, and just make sure it still runs and the wheels are not touching. You don't have much play in there, so they can be glued in place. So next have the boiler and smoke box. Do not glue these together, it makes it easy accessible to fit batteries when you want to take them in and out, or if you want to put a charging jack on it somewhere, you can. It's got a big slot down the side of it, that's just because the motor then can be slid over the top, so when the motor's in place, that can literally slide over. Clips into place. It's always going to be centre because there's a little notch inside. Slide that over to make sure it all fits, which you know it does. Take that off. Inside you have two hexagons to fit two 3mm nuts, glue them in place inside so you know they're not going to fall out when you keep taking on and off to replace the batteries. Glue that into place, slide that over using two bolts from underneath, bolt the smoke box into place. Next, the dome, very easy, got a hole in the boiler, bolt into place. Then you have your safety valve bracket, which gets glued on the top and slides in the two slots into the cab. So, it looks like that. So you glue that on the top once you're happy. Do not glue the things into the slot so you can slide it on and off quite happily. Next you have a backing piece to go inside the cab. When you fit electrics, it's been designed that some parts can go in here, receiver or speed control or whatever you want to fit in there really, and it's got a hole going through so you can fit stuff underneath or go to the motor. Then you take your plate, which has two square little slots, push that in so you have a nice little cover to cover all your electrics. There is a hole that you can either use the 2.5mm screw provided, but be careful you do not break the bracket, or you can make something cut where you can clip it into place, so you can remove it if necessary. Once you've done that, take your, shame to say it, it's now plastic card, not 3D printed. Just quicker and easier for me just to cut rather than print. Glue that onto place on the top. So you have yourself a toggle. If you have any questions or like to know any more information, it's fine. The kit does come with brass handrail material, so you can stick your bits and pieces wherever you like. And happy building. Thank you.